Forgetting to flip the laundry is a once-a-day thing for me, so today, we're gonna fix that. Now, I solved this problem 7 years ago, but it just doesn't work anymore. In version 1, I used vibration sensors to monitor the washer and the dryer. Fortunately, back then, I was still using an old washer and dryer that was free from a college roommate. The thing shook so hard that I could feel the spin cycle from my office in the second floor from across the house. So those sensors had no problem detecting when it was running. Fast forward a few years, and this is what we're working with. Those Samsung engineers really outdid themselves. The thing operates so smooth that the vibration sensors just don't work on it. So we're gonna have to go back to square one. Like, literally square one.
And my first thought was to put some kind of sensor on the mains and then determine if current was going through the washer or the dryer.
No matter how smooth the appliances are, they can't hide the fact that they're consuming power. Okay, here's the plan. We're gonna stick a sensor on the washer and the dryer, and when the dryer's finished, we're gonna blast out notifications every 5 minutes until the dryer starts. For the brains, we're gonna be using an ESP32 because they are dirt cheap and they have Wi-Fi. We need a way to monitor the power, and for that, we're gonna be using a sensor called a split core transformer. You run the wire you want to measure through this hole. On the other end, you get millivolts that are relative to the current going through that wire. The other thing that I used was an ADC. I found out later that I didn't really need this because we're not trying to measure the current exactly. We're just trying to determine if the washer is running. But it was free with the sensor, so I just used it anyways. All right, let's get to the real fun. Let's build it. Okay, here we are at the bench. We've got something to test the power. And we have our split core current sensors hooked onto a wire. Show you what that looks like. So this is just a standard 120 extension cord that I've stripped insulation back so I can isolate and put the two split cores on there just for testing. You can see where it was flat lined and then it spiked up, and now we're looking at the current from the current sensor. Everything prepped on the hardware side, we just need to write the firmware now. Here's a quick pro tip for these kind of projects. If you can simulate the environment, then you can save yourself a lot of time. Imagine the development cycle for this thing. You make your changes, you upload the firmware, you do a load of laundry, and that whole thing's gonna take like an hour. So I needed to come up with a way to speed this up. I mean, it's gonna take forever. So I ran the washer a few times and I logged all the sensor values. Then I could simulate what's going on in Python, and this cut the dev cycle from like an hour to maybe a second. You can see where the red line represents where the code thinks the appliance is running, and it worked great for the dryer. But for some reason, the same parameters didn't work for the washer. You can see where it's not going up at all. So it was pretty quick to just change the parameters until I got where I could detect that the washer was running. This took less than an hour, and it saved me days worth of laundry testing. Okay, with that working, let's move on to notifications. In version 1, I leveraged sending text through Gmail. However, in the past, they've turned off the ability to do that. So we're gonna go a different route. Lucky for me, I've installed wiretaps all through the house, and I'm gonna use them to blast out notifications. Alexa has a built-in feature called Routines, and it lets you create custom tasks like turning on your lights or turning on your favorite TV show. And there's a free service out there called Cynric Pro that lets you trigger these routines, and they have an excellent GitHub repo with plenty of examples. And with a few lines of code, this happens.
Please flip the laundry.
So let's plug it all in and give it a go.
Please flip the laundry.
Everything was going great until I remembered this feature. That blinking light means that the washer is requesting that we run a self-clean cycle. And this cycle takes about 4 hours, so I usually try to run it at night when everyone's asleep. You might already see the problem. There is no clothes in the washer to move to the dryer, so to keep this from happening,
please flip the laundry.
So we just need to update the firmware to filter out the self-clean cycle, and this thing's done.
Well, that wraps up this one.
Please flip the laundry.